Hey guys, what's up? This is Joseph Elliott coming to you guys again with another video. So in today's video, I want to talk to you guys about this wonderful application, Portraiture. Now, I know some of you might be working photographers, like you do a lot of shoots and you have a lot of these images to process, and you might be looking for a way to kind of like streamline your retouching. And one of the applications I've found to really help me out is Portraiture. I tend to use Portraiture for my skin retouching. Well, not all the time, but most times, like for, I would say maybe 80% of my work I do, especially for like those jobs where I'm not really looking for that, like not a beauty commercial, but maybe something very simple, like, you know, like portraits and family portraits and events and things like that. So here's the Portraiture application. This is version 2.3 or something like that. I'm not really sure. I'll find out. But there's a newer version, but this is the version I use. Now, when you open up your image, oh, you know what? I'm going to go back to the main image. All right, so this is the image. It's an image I shot sometime last year, one of my models. And if you have Portraiture installed, it'll be under Filter, Imagenomic, Portraiture. So when you go that, you come in here, and basically you have some presets over here that come in by default. Like these are generic presets, like this is the default preset. Now, one way I've seen most people use Portraiture is they just tend to like use one of these presets, and you know, like for example, like glamour, and they run it and they click okay, like okay, this outputs a new layer, and like we'll just wait for it to run, and voila, and this is it. And you know, this is a cool, if this is what you're going for, but I'm going to show you how I use Portraiture. Now, I use Portraiture in combination with frequency separation. So I'm going to run frequency separation on this image. And okay, here is my frequency separation action. If you guys don't know how to do frequency separation, I'm going to put a link to my previous video where I talked about how I do my frequency separation. So I'm going to select radius of 15 and click okay. And it's going to run that, and voila. So I have my low layer and high layer inside here. So I'm going to go to the low layer, and I'm going to go Filter, Imagenomic, Portraiture. And I'm going to run Portraiture on this. Now, I've already created my presets, and this is the presets I use. I have fine on 13, medium on 13, large on 13, threshold on 13, feather is 18, opacity fuzziness 100, and this mask is off. Now, don't worry about these figures over here. I'm going to tell you what they mean, explain what they mean later. And I always output to a new layer. I make sure that create transparency mask is off. And then, so how I run Portraiture, this eyedropper tool over here, you're going to use this and you are going to pick a skin tone. And once you click on it once, you see that it changes to the second one, which has a plus. So basically, anywhere you click is going to be added to that original selection that you did. So what you want to do is that you want to make sure that you have most of the skin tone. Most of the skin tone is appearing over here. Anything that is white, Portraiture is not going to be applied to it. Anything that has color, Portraiture is going to be run on it. So I'm going to click down here. I'm just going to try and get like a full selection. I'll take my image off, try and get that. Sometimes you might not be able to get everything, so just try and get the best that you can get, and I think that's fairly okay. So I'm going to click OK and let that run. All right, and you can already see that that has made a huge difference if I turn it on and off. But the beautiful thing is that since this is in a separate layer, we can actually create a layer mask and, you know, paint it on. So I'm going to take my flow to 3, and I'm just going to paint it on just the areas that I want. So you can see right now that it's done a really, really, really good job of smoothing out the tones. And you know what? Sometimes those settings I use might not be enough. We can delete this, go back, filter, image dynamic, portraiture. And this time I'm going to increase everything to the maximum. Okay. And click OK. And we're getting a bit more smoothing again. We're going to add a layer mask. I'm going to paint in there. Paint everywhere. Try and careful not to paint the eye. And you can see now it's even done even more smoothing. So I hope you guys found this helpful. You know, you can use Portraiture to really speed up your workflow. I know a lot of people, there are lots of different ways of retouching skin, cleaning skin. Some people use mixer brush, some people use the blow tool. But you know, I kind of find this to be a better method for me. So I hope it was really helpful to you guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, make sure to like it, give it a thumbs up, maybe drop a comment below, and please subscribe to this channel for more tutorial videos and other videos in the future. So get it, good. Later, guys.